Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 1.2, Problem 9. This is Problem 9 from Section 1.2. It says, suppose that the supply function is P equals S parentheses Q equals 0.3Q plus 2.7, where P is the price and Q is the quantity. Suppose also that the market price is $4.50, and when the quantity demanded is 2, the price is $6.10. Find the demand equation. So this is kind of a difficult problem. So they're giving you just enough information to find the demand equation. So from the given information, we have to find the demand equation. So to start off, what you need to remember is the demand equation is a linear equation. So to find a linear equation, we're going to use the formula y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. This is the formula that will help us find almost all linear equations, whether it's supply, demand, or something else. So to fill this in, we're going to either need 2 points or a point and a slope, and that's really what we have from the given information. But you have to spend a little bit of time realizing what they're telling you with the given information. So to fill in our formula for the equation of a line, I think it helps if I draw a little bit of a graph. It's not required, but it'll be helpful. So let me just make a quick graph. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And that should be enough. Now the question tells us that the supply equation is P equals S parentheses Q equals 0.3Q plus 2.7. So that supply equation is a line that's going to go up as you go from left to right. And we can label that supply. And we can write underneath P equals S parentheses Q equals 0.3Q plus 2.7. That's part of the given information. Now next it says that the market price is $4.50. Let me come back to that for a minute. The next piece of information says when the quantity demanded is 2, the price is $6.10. That piece of information is a point on the demand equation. When the quantity demanded is 2, the price is $6.10. So if we go over 2 for quantity and up 6.10, 6.10 is not actually a point on the graph, but we can sort of estimate it. We have over 2 up 6.10. Okay. Over 2 up 6.10. Now, that's one point. We need to find the second point on the demand equation or the slope. Now that market price is $4.50 is what's going to give us our second point. It's not a slope. So the fact that the market price is $4.50, what that's telling you is if you could see the demand equation, it's going to go down as you go from left to right, and it's going to go through this point. That's going to be demand. Now, the fact that the market price is $4.50, what that's telling you is the point at which they intersect, one of the coordinates is 450. Now, you have to, you know, get the right value. Is that P or is it Q? It's P, P for price, 450 is P, and P is typically equivalent to Y in these supply and demand equations. So the Y coordinate is $4.50. Now what we have to do is find the x coordinate, and we'll have two coordinates, and we'll be able to use our formula for the equation of a line, y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. Now, how can we find the x-coordinate, or for supply and demand, the q-coordinate? I mean, you can sort of estimate it by eye. If my graph is drawn accurately, it looks pretty close to 6, but you can't really go by eye. What we're going to do, this point with a y-coordinate of 450 is on both the supply and the demand. Well, the supply, I can find any point I want because they gave me the equation. So let me take the supply equation. Let me write it horizontally here. P equals S parentheses Q equals 0.3 Q plus 2.7. And again, I don't like to write it with the extra set of equal signs in the S here. S is to designate that it's supply, but when I'm actually going to use it, I prefer to write it with one equal sign. So I'm going to write P equals 0.3 Q plus 2.7. Now, what I have here is a value for P. $4.50 is P for price. So I'm going to take the equation for supply that I started writing and put in 4.50 for P equals 0.3 Q plus 2.7 and do the math required to solve for Q. What value of Q makes that equation true? So to find that out, let me move the 2.7. I'll start with that. So negative 2.7 on the right, negative 2.7 on the left. I don't need the zero. So now if I subtract, what I'm going to get is, let me see, that should be 1.8, if I'm doing my math right, equals 0.3 Q. So now if 1.8 equals 0.3 Q, I want Q, not 0.3 Q, so let me divide out the 0.3 that's in front of the variable I want to solve for. And 1.8 divided by 0.3 does come out to 6. You can just ignore the decimals if you want to do it without the calculator, 18 over 3. Or if you don't see that, just use your calculator. Do 1.8 divided by 0.3 equals, and you'll see it's 6. So Q is equal to 6. The Q coordinate, or what's equivalent to the X coordinate, for this point where they intersect is 6. So now, after that work, I have basically 2 points. This whole problem becomes find the equation of the line that goes through the point 2, 6, 10 and 6, 450. So to do that, I'm going to use y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1 and fill in a number value for y1, for m, and for x1. Now to fill this in, let me label my points. This point I consider to be the first point. It's further to the left. It's up higher, so it'll be point 1. Therefore, its x value of 2 will be x1, and its y value of 6, 10 will be y1. This point seems logical to label as point 2. Looks like the second point. Therefore, its x value of 6 will be x2 for point 2, and its y value of 450 will be y2, because it's part of point 2. And when I fill the formula for the equation of a line in, I will need a value for m, the slope. So before I even start with this, off to the side, let me write m equals y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. And fill in the values as I have them labeled. So now m is y2, so as I look at my graph, the value of y2 is 4.50, then minus y1, my value for y1 is 6.10, and underneath x2, my value of x2 is 6, then minus from the formula, and then x1, my value for x1 is 2. So as I do the subtraction in the numerator of the slope formula, I have $4.50 minus $6.10. So when you do that subtraction, it is negative $1.60. You don't really need the zero at the end, but since it's money, I like to think of it. More importantly, don't forget the negative. It's not $1.60, it's negative $1.60. Big difference. In the denominator of my slope formula, I have 6 minus 2, which is 4, positive 4. And now that's going to give me a negative 0.40, or just negative 0.4. Again, if you don't see it easily, just use your calculator. Negative 1.60 divided by 4 equals, and the calculator will tell you pretty easily that m is negative 0.4. Now that I figured out m, and I have x1 and y1 labeled, I'm ready to fill in my formula for the equation of a line. Y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. I put in a number value for y1, for m, for x1, and the rest of the formula stays the way it is. So this y will stay, this minus will stay. y1, so if I look, y1 is 6.10 equals, then m, I have to put a number value for m, m is negative 0.4. Again, don't forget the negative. It'll make a big difference in the end. Negative 0.4. Then this parenthesis stays. Next piece is x. That'll stay because it doesn't have an underline. Next piece is minus. Now, x1 in the formula I put an underline under, we have to put in a number value. My value for x1 is 2. Close the parentheses. And now that's the answer, but that's not really in the best form. First, I should put it into y equals mx plus b form, and then I can switch the variables out to p for price and q for quantity. That would be better. So this is the right answer, but it's really not in the right form yet. So first of all, let me clear these parentheses. Y minus 6.10 equals negative 0.4 times x is negative 0.4x. And then negative 0.4 times negative 2 is positive 0.8. So that's cleared the parentheses. Now let me get the y by itself. So I'm going to add 6.10 to each side. So plus 6.10 on the left, plus 6.10 on the right. So now I'm going to have y equals negative 0.4x plus, so I have the 6.10 plus another 0.8, or 80 cents if you like to think of it in terms of money, is going to be $6.90. Now it's in y equals mx plus b form, and to really do a nice job, I should switch the y over to a p for price, and the x over to a q for quantity. So we had gotten our equation for demand down to y equals negative 0.4x plus 6.90. And I had said that that is the right answer, but since it's in the form of a demand equation, it should have a p for price and a q for quantity. So the p replaces the y for price, and this negative 0.4x becomes negative 0.4q, and the 690 stays. And now if you really want to make it look like what a math book would do, you can even add that extra parenthesis, or not extra parenthesis, extra equal sign to make it look like what's in most math books, and put D parentheses Q, really designating this as a demand equation. And I will leave the negative 0.4q plus $6.90. And that would be the final answer. That's the demand equation. And from that, if you have any quantity, you can find the price. Or if you have any price, you can find the quantity that's demanded.